As we look around the United States, we often think, has a better country ever been led by worse people? Probably not. So in our spare time, we've looked around the world. We try from time to time to bring leaders on this show from other countries who actually care about their people. That's why we went to Hungary this summer to talk to Viktor Orban. But he's not the only one. When we spoke to Orban, he mentioned other countries in Central Europe that have defended their populations against international interference. And one of the countries he mentioned was Poland.
In the last few nights in Budapest, I've run into a number of Americans who have come here because they want to be around people who agree with them, who agree with you. Do you see Budapest as a kind of capital of this kind of thinking?
The capital of that kind of thinking, or one of the capitals, because the other Central European countries are also very competitive and producing very nice ideas and organizing that kind of communities of conservative and Christian Democrats thinkers as we do.
Andrzej Duda is the president of Poland, and we're honored to be joined by him right now. Mr. President, thank you so much for joining us. We know that you're watching what's happening in the United States, and you're watching this massive flow of migrants over our border. It will total over 1 million just this year. Something very similar happened to Europe in 2015. The EU pressured Poland and other nations in Central Europe to accept, and Poland fought back. Tell us why you did that.
No, odpowiedź jest bardzo prosta. Myśmy się po prostu nie zgadzali wtedy w 2015 roku na tak zwany system.
The answer is very simple. We did not agree back then in 2015 to the so-called quota system, which was proposed by some of the EU member states, which means that every single country would have to accept a given number of migrants. And we gave a very clear answer to that. Whoever wants to come to Poland, whoever is looking for help, assistance, especially refugees who are looking for shelter because they are threatened by war, persecuted in their own countries, if they want to come to Poland, we want them to stay in Poland, live in Poland. Well, to accept such a person and to help them, we did not agree to relocate Poland people by force. We do not agree to keep these people in prison. If these people did not want to stay in Poland, they would want to leave. And we're not going to make anybody stay. We're not going to keep anybody against their will. It is very simple. Everybody is a free person. Everybody should be respected, whether it's a migrant, whether it's a refugee, whether it's whoever else from European Union. They have the right to come and the right to leave. So we said, whoever wants to come to us, let them come. We are not going to have somebody brought here by force. It was our answer, and we stick to that response.
How did your voters, the citizens of Poland, feel about the decision of the Polish government to say no to the quotas?
Większość osób się z tym zgadzała, bo to jest prosta argumentacja dla Polaków, bardzo zrozumiała. Polacy w ogóle są ogromni.
The majority of people agree with that. The argument is very simple for the Poles. The Polish people are very sensitive about the issue of freedom, because for many, many years, we were behind the Iron Curtain. There was no freedom, and the people had no passports, because the communist regime issued passports to only those who were obedient, and society rebelled. Society wanted to have freedom. There was no freedom of speech. And I said the Poles are very sensitive about this. So this is imprisonment. The kind of bondage that these people would have to submit to was against the people's will. And that is why the majority of Poles supported that decision for the Polish government.
Understandable. So you're saying that for 40 years, Poles had no freedom of speech and their movement was controlled by the government. As you watch what's happening in the United States, where people have lost their freedom of speech and their movement is being controlled by the government, do you have any message for the American people?
I'm not going to advise anything to the American people. American people have enjoyed democracy for hundreds of years. We can say, I think, that they know very well what they need. They can make their own decisions. In the elections, they elect their representatives. They elect their president. And as I'm saying, they have got a huge experience living in a free country, a beautiful country, which is a dream to many people around the world. They know very well what they need.
The American president, Joe Biden, before he became president, described Poland as unfree, as an authoritarian place. How have your dealings with the Biden administration been since he's become president?
To, co pan powiedział przed momentem, jest rzeczywiście przykrą sprawą, ponieważ to są kłamstwa na temat Polski, które przede wszystkim przedstawiciele dzisiejszej polskiej opozycji politycznej opowiadają na temat obecnej władzy. To jest po prostu
what you just said is indeed very regrettable thing, because there are a lot of lies spread about Poland. In the first and foremost, what some representatives of the Polish opposition are saying about the current Polish government is totally untrue. And the best proof of that is in the fact that the incumbent government has won the election. They won the election back in 2019. I'm thinking about the parliamentary election. They've got again the absolute majority in the Polish parliament. This is the second time in history since 1989 since we have regained free parliamentary elections. For the second time in a row, we have got a single camp in the absolute majority of parliament. I was re-elected as president of Poland. I am coming from the same political camp, so please believe me. If there was no freedom in Poland, if any one of those powers tried to strip people of their freedom, they wouldn't have been elected. Simply said, people are happy with their government right now. They think that this government cares for their interests, that this government keeps electoral promises, and this is why they were re-elected. But of course, some representatives of the opposition are really furious because they are not able to win elections. As I have said, they lost twice in a row. They also lost the presidential election, so because of that, they are slandering the current political camp. But let me reiterate, fortunately, it is the people who choose.
That makes sense. So Viktor Orban told us that organizations, NGOs funded by George Soros had pushed hard to force Hungary to open its borders. In the United States, we're seeing NGOs funded by George Soros facilitate, help the movement of tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of migrants into our country. Has Poland had problems with NGOs funded by George Soros?
Czy jeżeli chodzi o finansowanie, to tutaj jest mi trudno powiedzieć. Nie będę w tej sprawie zabierał głosu. Natomiast powiem tak, oczywiście, że są bardzo różne organizacje. Tak jak powiedziałem, no mamy w Polsce wolność słowa.
But about funding, it's hard for me to say. I'm not going to speak about it, but of course there are a lot of different organizations. As I said, we got freedom of speech in Poland. We also have the freedom of assembly. So there are different organizations of liberal nature. There are more conservative ones. There are different kinds of institutions. Some of them are pro-ecological. We have got all sorts of organizations, also those supporting the youth. And of course, there are those who want us to have open borders for migrants, and a lot of people share these views. However, today, we are struggling with the migration crisis on our eastern border. That is the border between Poland and Belarus, because totally irresponsible and even crazy as for international standards behavior, the Belarusian authorities is something that we are witnessing. They are bringing by plane, actually people from the Middle East, for instance, from Syria or Iraq, and then the Belarusian authorities are moving those people to our border. They're like the border with Latvia and Lithuania. And in fact, those people are being pushed by force into our country. They are not going through the border crossings. They are crossing the border illegally. And today, our border guards, together with the Polish soldiers, are watching the border, protecting it very closely. Because we're not only talking to the protection of the Poland. And in fact, those people are being pushed by force in our country. They are not going through border crossings. They are crossing the border illegally. And today, our border guards, together with the Polish soldiers, are watching the border and protecting it very closely. Because we're not only talking about protection of Poland, and we are not only making sure that the law is not being violated, but first and foremost, we are fulfilling our European duty. Our eastern border is the border of the European Union and the border of the Schengen zone. And it's our duty to protect this border from illegal migration. And that is what we are doing in a very decisive way. And of course, that arouses many discussions. But let me reiterate, the majority of Polish people support these activities. And this is why we are doing that. As I said before, this is an issue of responsibility before our people, responsibility also before the countries with whom members of European Union. So we are just implementing our duties to this respect. And the persons who's crossing the border, because of course, such cases also happen, they're unavoidable. Those people are helped and assist. They are provided with all the services that we are obliged to provide them, according to the EU law. So we are fulfilling our task that way. We are also protecting the border. We believe this is important. Of course, there are organizations that are politicians who think that everybody should be let in. We cannot do that.
No, you can't do that. So in the United States, the technology companies, Google, Twitter, Facebook, have enormous influence over our government. I think everyone would agree that that's true. The government of Poland recently pushed back against the power of these countries. Will you tell us what the Polish government has done and why?
Nie no, polski rząd nie wprowadza żadnych ograniczeń, jeżeli chodzi o media społecznościowe. Tutaj jest tutaj pełna.
The Polish government is not introducing any kind of restrictions on social media. There is full freedom of action, of course, within the limits of law-abiding in Poland. And in respect, we have got freedom. As I said, Polish people are very sensitive about the freedom of speech, first and foremost. By the way, many of the youths in Poland, in Twitter, we use Twitter to communicate. And for the number of politicians, it is also an important source of information. So there are no limitations here in that regard.
So in Poland, is it legal for Twitter to censor political views?
No. Podobna jest sytuacja jak w Stanach Zjednoczonych. To znaczy, nie słyszałem o tym.
Well, the situation resembles the one in the United States. In other words, I have not heard about it. Such a situation happening. But theoretically, it is possible. But of course, I would never support it. Absolutely. I believe this is the one with ways limitations of freedom of speech. Of course, this also is an issue of responsibility. However, if somebody trespasses the red state line and slanders someone, then this person can be sued. Of course.
Well, that would be nice to see. Finally, let me ask you about Poland's family policy. So Poland, from the outside, appears to have decided to help encourage Polish couples to have children. Please tell us what you're doing and why you've done it.
Zacząć trzeba od tego, że w naszej konstytucji jest zapis, że małżeństwo i rodzina znajdują się pod szczególną opieką ze strony państwa. Małżeństwo jako związek kobiety i mężczyzny. Wprost taki jest zapis konstytucyjny. I w związku z tym my właściwie po raz pierwszy od 1989 roku podjęliśmy zdecydowane działania prorodzinne. Tak jak zresztą zobowiązaliśmy się, ja się jeszcze zobowiązywałem jako kandydat na prezydenta w 2015 roku, że działania prorodzinne zostaną podjęte. Zaproponowaliśmy, zapowiedzieliśmy, mówię tutaj zarówno ja w mojej kampanii, jak i później moje koleżanki i koledzy, którzy startowali w kampanii wyborczej parlamentarnej, że wprowadzimy taki program, który nazwaliśmy 500+.
The Constitution stipulates that marriage, it says a union of a man and a woman and family are protected by the government in a special way. So the first time since 1989, we have embarked upon a very resolute and vast pro-family action. And when I was running for president back in 2015, I also made a pledge, and I said that we would start a pro-family policy. We offered, we actually announced, myself during the campaign, and later I was joined by my colleagues who were also running for the parliamentary election. So we pledged that we would introduce a program by the name of 500+. It is a welfare program for families in its initial version. We were testing, actually. We decided that starting from the second child in a family, parents of every child monthly receive 500 zlotys, sum of $130, a kind of welfare for many from the state in a raising children. It was exceptional in part. It turned out to be revolutionary in Poland. Never before did families experience such help. Those families were very often in difficult situations, especially families with many children. In Poland, the salaries were still not equal to Western Europe or the salaries in the United States, where some products are similarly priced or even more expensive than those in the United States or Western Europe, which means that the living standard for many families and many children were quite low. It was very difficult for them to make ends meet. But it was a revolution for them when they received the money. And by the way, the program was working fine, amended our law. And now parents of every single child receives 500 zlotys a month, starting from the first child. So even families with one child get 500 Polish zlotys. We did not expect the program to have such wonderful effect. Just imagine the poverty among children has been limited to more than 90%. Thanks to the support, which seems to be quite limited, because the 500 Polish zlotys is around $130. In other words, it is not an exorbitant sum of money. This program was revolutionized in Poland. I think nobody can imagine not to have the 500+ program in Poland. That was the best thing, definitely the best social program that we have been able to introduce. But to me, a politician, speaking openly, I consider myself to be rather conservative, and I actually was always frank about my views. I'm a Christian. I'm a practicing Christian. I pray. I'm not ashamed of that whatsoever. And to me, the value of family is priceless. I do support families. I'm pro-life. I defend life. I believe that life is sacred. I believe it should be guarded, and families have to be supported as strong as they can, because family is the foundation of every nation. Everything is based on family. Therefore, the support with which we offer families for the political perspective, from my personal perspective, is key importance. We also have used other programs supporting families. We support parents with their child starting schools with programs dubbed 300 zlotys. So we pay 300 zlotys to the parents of every child going to school to buy a set of books, a rucksack, and pens, pencils, stationery, whatever the child needs starting school. That is a very difficult moment when the school year begins. We know that families have to spend more money, so it turned out that 300 zlotys is important for the families. And it also contributes quite big support on top of the 500 plus, which every family gets per child.
It's inspiring to hear that. I wish we had it. Mr. President, thank you for sitting down and talking to us tonight. We appreciate it. It's good to see you.